What is up, guys? Welcome back to another reaction of the seven deadly sins. This is chapter 288 and 89. The title is God. You heard me, it's God. So Escanor and Ludocile, they're both teaming up. I mean, Ludocile should know about Sunshine a lot more, so he should be able to come up with the tactics pretty quickly. I think that's what he did. Probably from past experience or something he probably thought of if he's gonna face demon, you know, from 3000 years ago. Looking forward to seeing what this is. This might have happened in the past as well, but who knows, it might not. Just a prediction. And also, when it's come to the promise with Zeldris and Melidas about Gila, basically Zeldris' girlfriend. So if you remember, end of the vampire arc one, the castle was destroyed because of Escanor, and then also when it's come to the hall that was made by Melidas. So I personally think that's what happened, that he sealed her and then made that hole, destroy the entire thing. But if he didn't seal her, that means he's dead. So this is a lie. So I'm looking forward to finding out the truth. It will be really interesting. But yeah, let's see. So this is, where are we? Napping, Death God. Oh, that's his title? I thought he's just called Napping. Former second captain of the Holy Knights. Head of the four archangels, candidate for the demon king, showdown between the holy and the evil, Belialin's daughter, pacifist demon, lion sin, the diamond holy knight. Okay, so their titles has been displayed in the first page. The pride tag is formed between Ludocile and Escanor to take on Zeldris, destroy the mysterious magic. Okay, and also when it's come to Zeldris, apparently he can only cancel out the magic, but he doesn't do exactly the same as Demon King, because he do have part of Demon King power, but not the full. But I honestly thought he can also absorb, like invert the magic, but apparently that's not the case. But anyway, let's go. Operation Goat, 288, let's go. I will fulfill my promise as soon as I gather that. Okay, wait, we are continuing with, he always keeping that in his head, as soon as I gather the Ten Commandments and become the Demon King. What I, Zeldris, am about to show you my true original. Okay, why are we getting this again? My power. Savior, well, I am praying. That's not a bluff. You cannot protect me from the stand back. Ah, what a shame. Yeah, it's look like we are no longer needed. Okay, so we actually got like a reminded of this scene again, that fact that he saying about that he's gonna serve Gila. I mean, he's gonna give Gila back, or like how he's gonna unseal her. Let's see. Okay, and Zeldris not even making a move with his cruel son coming at him. Like, no matter how powerful any ability is, there will be always a blind spot to it. Yeah, there will be always a weakness. It's just a matter of the time that you get killed before finding that weakness, or you find the weakness before you get killed. If he's just allowing us to attack him in order to counter-attack us, meaning if it uses the same principle as full counter, we simply need to calculate the timing of his counter-attack to coordinate our own. I don't think he's using full counter. Look at that. Everything just around that place is a mess. Okay, they're attacking, but they got deflected back. It's like, what? Okay, and Merlin is observing this. Okay. Ignore my sound effect. I'm terrible at it. Okay, and look at Zeldris. He looked like a badass. Okay. How was he able to see through our attacks? We obstructed his field of vision with the explosion from Escanor's attack. Our presence should have been camouflaged. Okay, and they are getting pulled back in. Like, this is a waste of time. Okay, you can see his the seal demon mark that's being actually thickened. It's almost like the assault mode Melidas demon. It's not almost, but it's becoming like that. I am going to get serious. What did he say? He's like, wait, is he gonna get serious now? So all this time he was just, you know, teasing them. Okay, let's see. This is a teaser. Now the full movie is coming out. Okay, what did he say? All right, what is that? Oh, wait. That's like a... I don't know if his blade always been like that, but that's like an edge just popped out. Okay, what is it? Okay, he is pulling in with all he got. He's multiplied... No, multiplied the speed and intensity of his vacuum. Okay, so he's actually... Sorry guys, I had to post the video. Okay, so he multiplied the intensity and also he's the speed that he's pulling in. Let's... Oh wow, even Merlin is getting pulled on. Okay, this is interesting. He's like, I won't be able to teleport in time. And you can see even the mark is not fully circled like how Melidas' assault mode is. But it's just thickened up a little bit. I'm not sure if he can actually pull up. And you can see even Hendrix and Ant, I think that's Gil Thunder, they're both getting in. Like, fine, first I will eliminate you and take the commandment. Okay, so he is determined that he wanna make Melidas the demon kick because he wanna see Gila. Whatever her name is. Let's see. Okay, this is gonna be interesting. Okay, and then see. Okay, he attacked. He's coughing out the... Oh, wait, no. Escanor actually became the shield for her. Okay, Escanor, I'm sorry. I just had to. I was powerless against my own heart. Merlin. Okay. Wait, no, even C actually got cut. The cut wasn't... Okay, I honestly thought he put his body front of it, but even then, see, still got damage. And you can see he's not happy. Oh boy. Okay, you know the cruel son? There's like 100 of them coming at from him. Look at this. Crazy prominence. Dude, that it's actually colliding with Meliadas as well. Okay, this guy is, well, it's not really affecting Zeldris. He's still on the stands. And... Okay, it's actually hitting Cusack and Chandler as well. You're trying to get me caught in this too? Oh wait, that's Ludo Seal screaming. But that's how you know he's actually went out of control. Let's see. Okay, Merlin wake up and look at the amount of... Okay, did anything happen? Okay, things are falling left and right. Did that fall top of Zeldris? Yeah, that's like a stone falling top of Zeldris, but let's see. Okay, it's like that's like a space that actually destroyed them into dust. Oh no, well, no, it's not like a space. It's not like a space. It's basically his sword was able to get that. There's like a certain area, he turned them into dust. Okay, she's like, I can't believe it. It's this simple and yet unparalleled in its brutality. His ability doesn't depend on his sense of sight or hearing. Or even feeling the presence of those around him. Okay, so this is like a fixed space. That's it, I think. The truth nature of Omnia's Nebula is through an extreme, ultimate state of concentration. He accelerates the darkness within his own body and spiral around him, creating a vortex that pulls in all living things around him with a terrifying force. Okay. As if air was suddenly introduced into a vacuum. Any and everything that enters that area will be shattered to ribbons with such a blinding speed that even the absolute spinal reflexes of living organism could not dodge them in time. Simply to put a name on it would be full react. Almost like full counter, but it's full react, okay? It's like he's moving faster than light, and that's not even an exaggeration. Okay, this is coming from a guy who hold a grayscale flash. Okay, he's able to even surpass the divine territory of my grayscale. Okay, there we go. He just set it out there. He accepted. Let's see. What of it? Okay, he doesn't seem happy about it. He let the hand go and is like, I have responsibility, a duty to win this holy war. As the head of the four archangels, and as the leader of Stigma. Okay, so he gave up on defense. He's going with all attack. Let's see. And look at Hendrickson. Mark. Okay, Hendrickson and Guild Thunder, they are not happy. Like, I sacrificed everything to accomplish that. Love? Friendship? Everything? Okay, where's this love part coming in? Is that for his brother because of mail? Okay, this is what he remembers from his memory. So I'm actually looking forward to seeing when this darkness. I think the darkness is what's stopping them from knowing the truth of about Mail and Estrosa. So I think when that goes away, when Melidas comes out of his cocoon, it should work out. Let's see. I simply cannot comprehend your despicable demons. And okay, Guild Thunder jumped front end because he know that's gonna hurt her body. And like, Guild, okay, Hendrickson jumping in, screaming, Guild Thunder, and okay, what just happened? I only see half of his body. Okay, all that's left are you. Okay, Escanor and Merlin, and also you can see Hendrickson's face on the other side. You persistent little cockroaches, just die already. Okay, you can see Kusak is not happy. Please just hang in there for 1 minute. All right, I'm done making a mistake. Oh, super combo teleport. Okay, what's happening? Okay, what? You are able to freely walk unaffected by my Omnius Nebula. Okay, this is basically Escanor having the one. I think that's where that 1 minute part coming in. Are you some kind of Okay, again, when a demon clan asks you, are you some kind of monster? You know they are strong. Okay, look at this. Like, be it Meliodas or Estrosa, it seems all you brothers are just dying to get the crap pounded out of you by me. Where have I felt this magic? Okay, so I think they are feeling the grace. Because I told you this before, right? He have the true knight as well. So imagine if he activate true knights now. This is what I would call a desperate situation. Let's see. And okay, his hand is coming in. The time has come. Written as the ultimate Vanglorious extension across heaven and earth. The one. Okay, look at this. He look ugly, to be honest. Not my favorite look from Escanor, but it doesn't matter because strength is what all you need at this point. Even at an overwhelming disadvantage, his pride never falters. The 1 minute is the only chance, the one step into action. For his 1 minute of high noon, he becomes the incarnation of invincibility and unparalleled strength. The one is unleashed. Okay, Pride vs. PT. That's the next title. Looking forward to that, which we're going to actually get to now. I don't know why I said that. But the thing is, right, now the Chandler saying, wait, where have I felt this magic before? If he's, remember, it's the grace of sunshine, I think he might activate True Knight. Who knows? Let's see. Let's go to the next chapter quickly. All right, Escanor's most powerful time, high noon, has arrived. Pride now clashes ahead of first against the Zeldris full react. Okay, and look at this. Who the heck is this guy? That's the cover page. Pride vs. PT. Okay, moving on to the first one. Oh, dude, look at his eyes. Even his eyes are on flame. The one. Okay. Wonder if Meliodas will react to this anyway. What the heck is he? He's able to stand up totally fine without suffering any effects of Omnius Nebula. And also remember, the more he use the power, the more damage he will do to his body. So yeah, the power, where have I seen it before? Okay, so Chandler is still trying to figure it out. You defeated Meliodas? If that's true, then that simply means that Meliodas wasn't being serious. He's far too powerful, but he has a bad habit of toying around with a stronger opponent to spite. Okay, so that is true. He was toying around. If he didn't wait until he turned the one, he would have been able to defeat Escanor. But I am different. Be my opponently a lion or a fly. Okay. I will vanquish them with all my might. Great. Look at him. Like, huh? Okay, did he just bring out his hand sword? Okay, what happened? Okay, I'm not sure what exactly. No, he's actually holding the axe. He's not using the hand sword. He's holding the axe. And did he just deflect it or what happened? Okay, look at everybody. Everybody seems shocked. Okay, even his push got pushed back. He's even able to repel Escanor's attack in his the one form. Okay, this is crazy. Impossible. He's hardly even left with a scratch. Okay. So, like, both sides are surprised because they are basically using the best of the attacks, right? You can see he have a scratch, and let's see. What happened? Oh, wow. There's a dent on the axe. Okay, look at him. Okay, he put away the sword. It seems you have no intention to throw down your weapon and beg for your life. Nope. Look at him. Escanor, divine swords. When you are too powerful, people, you yourself become the weapon. Okay, look at this. Okay, he is coming at with him everything he got. Let's see how this is gonna go. Okay. A karate chop? Okay, look at Kusak is kind of disappointed. Wait, are you seriously using karate chop? There is no living being that exists which can actually come within striking range of Master Zeldris in one piece while his Omnius Nebula is active. Yet, why is this human capable of this power, this much power? And you can see Chandler is still thinking. By the way, when it's mean no human being, I'm pretty sure that same goes for these guys. That's the reason why they are still stuck to the wall. Let's see. There's no mistaking it. That's a grace. It belongs to sworn enemy, the four archangels, male, the sun. Okay, so he figured it out. But that means he should know all the weakness as well. The power that supreme deity granted the goddess clan, but that's a human. Male graces likely fell from him after he died. And then over the long passage of time, it came to dwell within that human's body. Really? That's how it works? That's exactly what you mean, isn't it, Chandler? Yes. Okay, he's still going at it. And you can see his punch is there, and there's like a space that's like basically not letting his punch through. Let's see. I don't understand. This war is fate shared between the demon and goddess clan, the transcendent even time. So why would a human like you risk your own life to fight in it? For what reason? All for the sake of my friend. They forgot actually, you know, because they are fighting mainly. These guys are fighting for the sake of Meliodas, not because they care about the Holy War. Well, they do, but not much as they care about Meliodas. Okay, his punch, his slice, let's see. This is bad. He's being pinned down. Friends, with that cruel, wholehearted, emotional, don't make me laugh. He is not that kind of man that would have such a pure, naive, simple emotions. Okay. He doesn't know the fact that the real Meliodas escaped. And also the thing, guys, I totally forgot. This has been explained to me in Discord. Not once, but twice. I just remembered now. This is all happening simultaneously. That means, you know, Meliodas and Ban fight is actually happening right now. And also the fight between male/Escanor versus Gauther/King/Diane. That's also going on at the same time. So the truth, they don't know it yet. So this is before the truth revealed to the others. So at this point, they still believe in Escanor, not male. Okay, so this is something I totally forgot. So ignore the part about with the darkness and all that stuff. Okay, you can... what's happening? Oh, wait. He managed to break through it. And you can see Zeldris. He's actually struggling. He destroyed his nebula. What is this? Zeldris's power over the area has disappeared. Well done, Escanor. Okay, so this is the moment probably Merlin was waiting for. You succeed in forcing him to dispel his ominous nebula. And you can see he's actually getting need. Okay, he backed out. Let's see. You are not getting anywhere. Okay, this is a new weapon with one finger this time. Divine Spear Escanor. Oh, wow. Okay, he actually managed to hit. And you can see there's a sonic boom within that attack. Dude, he's coughing. Okay, it actually penetrated him. Master Zeldris. Pierce straight. Oh, okay, dude. Okay. Pierce straight through. He managed to wound him. However, he's not done. So this is the moment where he actually activates the true knight. Okay, let's see. Look at him. He fell down. Sir Escanor's form. They got us. Okay, see? He activated the true knight. Grin. Darkness. At that time, two magic powers were dispelled from Zeldris. Escanor had rendered him instantly unconscious from his attack to cause him to release his nebula. And the second one, but the Prince of Underworld woke instantly. The time he was out was a mere 0.8 seconds. And from that state, it would take the Demon King's power appropriately 1 second to reactivate. So this is, we are talking about milliseconds here, not even seconds. It's milliseconds, okay? And in that, okay, there was 0.2 seconds available and somebody used the grace. Gold shining. And look at everybody's reaction. And even Merlin is smirking. And let's see. Okay, Gil Thunder has fallen down from the hall. And I'm pretty sure he will be going screaming right now, Cusack. In that mere instant, the spreading darkness was blown away. A flash of divine light. And you can see there's been a straight up slash and also the sword also got cut. Let's see. Blinking before me will cost you a life. Okay, so now we basically getting to see what flash, like how serious the flash is, because before he wasn't really that effective. Now you can see that his guard is down. He's actually making a big breakthrough, breaking him with the sun and finish him with the light. The Grace tag team finally crushed the impregnable Zeldris. Okay, by the way, that one question, when Nebula got like deactivated, why didn't Cusack move? Like, was he shocked that it's got a break and he didn't really think about Zeldris gonna get attacked by the sun? I mean, like Escanor. So if I was there, if I was in Cusack's move, I would have moved to protect Zeldris. But yeah, he was a bit slow. But overall, a good chapter, and Chandler showing up at the same like right time. Crazy, but yeah, otherwise I think Escanor would have finished off Zeldris. I'm looking forward to the next two chapters, people. It's going to be really, really interesting to see what we're going to do, what's going to happen to Escanor, well, skinny Escanor, and what's going to happen to Gil Thunder as well. I don't think he's dead for good. He probably is knocked out. A lot of blood loss, so he had to get healed ASAP. So I'm looking forward to seeing what they're going to do with those two. Because at this point, they are useless in this battle. So I'm really looking forward to it. And then, so it's going to be like Merlin and Ludociel and Hendrix. And they three going to fight against, well, Cusack and Chandler. But yeah, I don't know how much Hendrix are going to be useful. But it will be interesting to see how they're going to take this from here on. And also when their memory going to be awakened, that's going to be like the key turning point. A lot of interesting thing. I still can't think of who's the final villain is. The two person I can think of at this point is Meliodas, because of all the commandments he's taking. And also the second one is the Demon King, because Demon King, when the emotional Meliodas escaped, he's like, all the plan I've been playing, you're going to ruin it all. So that means he had some sort of plan. I'm looking forward to seeing that, what that plan is as well. So let me know your thoughts, your reaction in the comment section. Hope you guys enjoy the reaction. As always, if you did, do leave a thumbs up. If you are new, make sure to subscribe. And stay safe, people. Have a wonderful day or night. And see you guys with more videos.